Hi everyone, welcome back to this series of project management key concepts from the project management body of knowledge. This one in particular is the Requirements Traceability Matrix. Now, what is the Requirements Traceability Matrix? Well, it's a grid or a matrix, which is funnily enough because that's what it's called, but it links the product requirements from their origin, so the requirements that we've gathered from our stakeholders and our customer, and it links those to the deliverables that we are ultimately delivering as part of our project. And so we're seeing that those deliverables satisfy the requirements that we've gathered. Now, it provides a structure for managing any changes to the product scope as the project goes along. So why do we do this requirements traceability matrix, and why do we create this? Well, the implementation of a requirements traceability matrix, it helps us ensure that each requirement adds business value by specifically linking it to the business and project objectives that we are delivering. It also provides a structure for managing those changes as we go along, as we saw. Now, the process of tracing those requirements will include a few different things as you go along your journey. First of all, we're gathering the business needs, the opportunities that we have, the goals and the objectives of the project. Obviously, the project objectives there, and the project scope and work breakdown structure deliverables. So we've got our requirements, we've turned those into the project scope, and then we've got our we've broken it down further into the actual small deliverables that we'll be delivering that our teams, each individual team, will be working on themselves. And so that's the most we can break it down to make it, you know, nice and easy to for people to work on in small increments. And we've got the product design, what's it going to look like, the product development, test strategy and test scenarios, because we're looking at the acceptance criteria, how does that match back to those requirements. So that's very important as part of the test strategy to make sure that those requirements are validated and those deliverables are validated by our customer. And lastly, the high-level requirements to the more detailed requirements that our customers or our stakeholders want. So there are a few attributes that we'll put into this requirements traceability matrix, and that will basically help define the key information about those requirements. So these attributes will include a unique identifier. So maybe it's number 103, for example, or you know, F75, whatever the actual identifier is that makes sense for the project that you're working on. A textual description, so an actual description of that particular requirement and that item, the rationale for its inclusion, who owns that requirement, and where it's come from, the priority, 1 to 5 is usually a good measure, but it could be anything from like a percent that you're using, the version of that requirement or the version of that deliverable, the current status and the status date. Now, when we're looking at that, we still also need to match that to the deliverables, which you'll see in the example directly from the PMBOK guide. You've got your requirements description over here, and then it's matched to that objective, which is exactly what we want, and the project objectives overall, so to make sure that we're still moving in that same direction that we want to. But ultimately, the WBS or the work breakdown structure deliverables, so those smaller pieces of work. What is the actual deliverable that's going to be delivering that requirement for this particular item? And you can see there's the ID or the unique identifier that they've used. So basically that's a way of matching it up. Then we can see, the customer can see, the stakeholders can all see how that particular deliverable adds the value that they wanted in the first place. And that is the requirements traceability matrix.